Welcome to Midweek Space Startup News. You can follow us on X at Space Startup Hub. So let's get into the Space Startup News this week. So the first article is on a new stealth startup called Moonshot Space, and this is from Israel. And they've just raised $12 million for electromagnetic launch. I've highlighted some of the articles, so let's just go over it quickly and then we'll discuss it. This startup has emerged from stealth with plans to build a new kind of launch system, and they've secured $12 million in funding. Moonshot plans to sell A&D primes, that's aerospace defense primes, the tech as a hypersonic test platform, but eventually they want to offer orbital launch services, and they're thinking of resupply of raw materials to orbit. So currently the plan is to build a scaled-down version of the accelerator that's capable of reaching Mach 6, and a full-scale version capable of reaching orbit later. Moonshot wants to use the technology to send raw materials that can withstand the shock of high acceleration launch. Moonshot has signed preliminary agreements with D-Orbit and Orbit Fab to use the system for their in-space refueling and servicing needs. Okay, that's the article. So this reminds me of another company that's doing something very similar called Longshot. And I did a video on them a while ago. And it's basically the same thing. It's a giant space gun that can shoot things into orbit. So I'm going to base my discussion on my knowledge of Longshot. And first of all, this is not a new idea. We can go back to Second World War, and we have the Germans building these giant guns. And then we have, in the 80s, we had the HAARP gun. This goes back a while. And this is just basically a gas gun. You use gas to accelerate payload in a pipe, and basically by timing the release of the gas, you can push the payload to higher and higher speeds. That's the physics behind it. So from the Longshot video, we can see that they have what they call TAM, which is Total Addressable Market. So they reckon the market in 2030 is worth $16 billion for hypersonic test and $50 billion for launch, over $1 trillion for satellites. So basically, there's a number of markets. The near-term market is hypersonic test to test hypersonic launch vehicles and also intercepting hypersonic vehicles. So this gas gun can be used for that initially, and you need speeds maybe 5-6 Mach, which is doable right now. But for orbit, you're going to need much higher speeds, probably Mach 15 or something like that. But you can start with 5 or 6. You can get contracts from the U.S. Department of Defense and so on, Space Force. And then you can work towards your larger gun that can shoot raw materials into space. Longshot reckons that's worth maybe $50 billion, and then the satellite's over $1 trillion. This is what Longshot looks like, and I assume that the Moonshot will look something similar as well. It's basically a long tube, and you can see the vertical structures, they hold gas, and as the payload is propelled forward, the gas is released, which pushes the payload to faster and faster speeds, and at the exit, it's traveling at 5 or 6 times the speed of sound. This is for a Mach 5 system, so Moonshot is targeting Mach 6. So you can see it consists of a projectile, which is a pusher plate, payload support and payload, and then booster, which is the vertical structures. And it says boosters push from behind, and that's how the system works. So that's very interesting, and that's the first story this week. A new space startup emerging from stealth, and they've got $12 million in funding. So we'll see how that goes. Okay, our next story is on another stealth startup that's just gone public called Reditus Space. So this article is from Payload, and they've got some exclusive information about this new company. Reditus Space emerged from stealth with plans for a reusable reentry vehicle that can offer quick turnaround flights for microgravity researchers and in-space manufacturers. Reditus expects to complete the build of its first spacecraft called Enos just a year and a half after its founding in October 2024, and they're planning to hitch a ride on a SpaceX rideshare mission next summer. We make the minimum viable version of everything. The company has received $7.1 million in seed financing, and the name of the company, Reditus, is Latin for return. So they plan for fully reusable flights in 2027, and scheduled to spend 2 months in orbit, hosting an undisclosed pharmaceutical R&D payload, and it then shoots through the atmosphere and splashes down for recovery off the coast of Florida. Reditus will attempt to reuse many of the components inside the spacecraft, including the propulsion system, avionics, and power systems, between flights 1 and 2. In its first flight, it will have a payload capacity of 40 kilos and will be able to survive speeds in excess of Mach 24, and it will be designed to fly over 20 missions each during the lifetimes, and the Reditus officials are confident that there's more than enough demand to support their reusable alternative because of a growing understanding that reentry vehicles could help fill the research and manufacturing gap that the orbiting lab will leave. That is the International Space Station that's scheduled to be deorbited in the 2030s. We provide a mid-deck locker in the same manner that you would get on the International Space Station. It just goes up and down a lot more efficiently. This is all I know about them, just that one article from Payload. So they've got $7 million in funding, and they're basically working on something similar to what Varda Space does with a reentry capsule. With a reentry capsule that can be used for manufacturing pharmaceuticals or materials or semiconductor manufacturing. It looks like they've got a rideshare mission on SpaceX next year. They hope to have a fully reusable vehicle in 2027 that can be used 20 times. So it's good to have competition. You have Varda Space, you have Intuitive Machines that's also working on a reusable vehicle. I guess you could include Sierra Space with their Dream Chaser vehicle as well. So there's a number of companies working on in-space manufacturing and re-entry technology. Also, Atmos Space Cargo, the German space startup with its IAD, the Inflatable Atmospheric Decelerator. So we'll see where that goes. Okay, let's move on to our next story, and that's on Skyrora, which is a UK space startup that's working on an orbital vehicle. They recently posted on X, and it says, successful testing. On Friday, our qualified engines passed a key test milestone and will soon move into first stage integration. And they posted a video, so we'll just have a quick look at that. They're based in Scotland, and they will be flying from the Saxeford spaceport in the Shetland Islands. And this is testing the first stage engine called Skyforce. So this is a qualification test. It's a key milestone for the engine. And soon they'll be able to move on to first stage integration. So I think it's nine engines on the first stage, and then they have a second stage, and I think they also have a third stage. So there you go. That's the video they posted. So they've been testing the second stage. This is one of the tests. They've also been working on the Skylark L, which is a suborbital vehicle. They've flown this from Iceland once. They'll be flying it from Scotland next year. They already have a launch license, but the Saxeford spaceport can't accommodate a flight this year. So it's going to be sometime in 2026, and that will help them verify certain components, avionics, guidance, navigation, control, and so on for their orbital vehicle. We have some graphics of their layout for their spaceport, and you can see the tank farm, the integration warehouse, and also the launch pad. You can see from the graphic, the first stage has 9 Skyforce engines, and ISP is about 250 seconds at sea level and 285 in vacuum. And there's a second stage, and then there's a third stage or kick stage. One interesting thing about Skyrora is they were not selected for the European launch competition. There were 5 European space startups that received funding. I think they were PLD Space, Isar Aerospace, Maya Space, Arbex, and RFA. Okay, our next story is on Isar Aerospace. I'll bring up the article. So they signed a contract with the European Space Agency, ESA, to launch the Sindio-3 mission. And this will be launching from Andøya Spaceport in Norway, Q4 2026. Our launch manifest is filling rapidly as our global commercial and institutional customers recognize the value of flexible, cost-effective access to space. ESA's and the European Union's growing trust in Isar Aerospace for new missions to help build sovereign space capabilities for Europe. Redwire is a prime contractor for the Sindio-3 mission, using their Hammerhead spacecraft for a launch aboard Isar Aerospace's launch vehicle Spectrum to a low Earth orbit. The spacecraft aggregates 10 innovative payloads from 6 countries. We are confident in the capability of Isar Aerospace to ensure a safe and reliable launch, bringing the mission to orbit very soon. So that's the article. Isar Aerospace has only launched once, and the mission failed after 30 seconds. So it still has a long way to prove, first of all, it can get into orbit, and it can deploy a payload into the correct orbit. But they are already working on their second flight. The hardware's already at Andøya, and they're building the hardware for the third rocket as well. They're well-funded. They got over 400 million euros in funding. They're also funded by the European Launch Competition. So fingers crossed they can make progress and launch the vehicle and get to orbit soon. Okay, on to our final story about Relativity Space, which is a US space startup. So I'll bring up the article here. And this says that SES, satellite communication company, and Relativity Space have expanded their MLA for Terran R. So MLA is multi-launch agreement. Terran R is a reusable medium launch vehicle. So the article goes on to say SES, earlier this month, extended a multi-year multi-launch services agreement with Relativity Space, which is building the Terran R rocket, which is a medium to heavy lift reusable launch vehicle. And we'll talk more about the vehicle in a moment. Let's just read the article first. So it goes on to say, with this new agreement, Relativity's Terran R will provide SES with high performance, reliability, and affordable access to space. Terran R's first launch is currently planned for late 2026 from Cape Canaveral, Florida. And the CEO of SES says, deepening our collaboration with Relativity Space and Terran R demonstrates that commitment, pairing reusable medium to heavy lift capability with SES's multi-orbit vision to deliver more capacity more quickly and with greater resilience for years to come. So that's the article. So Relativity Space has already flown one rocket, and that's the Terran 1. And this is the Terran 1, which launched, I think, in 2023. So they only launched this vehicle once, and then they pivoted to the medium to heavy lift vehicle. This is a 3D printed vehicle. I believe 80% of the parts and components were 3D printed. They're now pivoting to the medium lift vehicle, which is the same as Rocket Lab, going from Electron to Neutron. And the same with Firefly, now moving on to Eclipse. And there you can see the stage one engine, 13 engines. On the second stage, one vacuum engine. And this is the flight profile, liftoff, main engine cutoff, stage separation, then entry burn, and then a landing burn. So the first stage is reusable, and they're making progress with the landing pad. This is in Cape Canaveral. And here we have a graphic of the Terran R vehicle. So it's 23,000 kilos to low Earth orbit, over 5,000 to GTO, and 33,000 kilos in expendable configuration. So you can see stage one, grid fins, stage two, interstage and fairing. And here's another graphic of the payload capacity. So compared to something like the Neutron from Rocket Lab, which is 13 tons, this is 20 tons in reusable configuration, but could be up to 30 tons in a expendable configuration. So its payload capacity is higher than Neutron and is slightly higher than Falcon 9, which is about 21, 22 tons. So this is something like 23 tons, well, 20 to 23 tons. And I don't know how many of you remember this video. This is going back a couple of years, but I find it quite interesting. So we bring it up. And this is an agreement between Impulse Space and Relativity Space. So Impulse Space are working on space tugs, lunar landers, as I did a video on them recently. So this is an agreement for Impulse Space to send a vehicle to Mars, launched on a Terran vehicle, Terran R, I guess. So this is going back a few years. I don't even know whether the agreement is still in place, but it shows the ambitions of both companies. Both Relativity Space and Impulse Space are interested in not just LEO, they're interested in the Moon and Mars. And they did have a video that showed them sending a lander to the surface of Mars. And we know Impulse Space is definitely working on a lander for the Moon. So there you go. That's a fairly old video, but I thought I'd bring it in. It shows the ambitions of both companies. And I think Eric Schmidt, the CEO of Relativity Space, who used to be the CEO of Google, is obviously a billionaire. And I think his ambition is similar to Elon Musk's and Jeff Bezos. He wants to build data centers and AI centers in orbit. And to do that, he needs a rocket company. And this is why he's put so much money into Relativity Space and why he's now the CEO. I think it's all to do with data centers and expanding into space. Without Eric Schmidt, I don't think that Relativity Space would exist anymore. And so that's it for this week. And just a heads up on my next video, I will be going back to the Moon. I'm going to be talking about some key locations on the South Pole of the Moon, which I think could be very soon be a contested area. You have the US-led program, you have the Chinese-led program. And if you look at the key locations on the Moon, they're all in very close proximity to each other. and I can see there being issues. You can think of the moon as like the eighth continent, and now there's a grab for resources, power, sunlight, lunar water ice. So everyone will be going to the same location, and that potentially could cause issues. So that will be my next video coming out probably Friday. Please check that out when it's done, and I'll see you next time.